and welcome to my channel. My name's Mary with Sewing for Madison. For today's project, we are going to do something totally unique, and it's possible that you have not even thought that you could do such a thing with your embroidery machine. We are going to be making a stuffy like this one, but in a bigger size. We're going to use the 6x10 size. This is the 5x7. This is a boomerang stuffy from Ohana Applique Designs. I'm going to put a link down in the description of where you can find this design. So, what makes this design unique in this project? Well, we're actually going to be making it into a dog toy. We're going to use fleece and burlap, and also a crinkle material on the inside. So if you've never embroidered with any of these materials before, stay tuned, you're gonna wanna watch this tutorial. Okay, for this project, you are gonna need one layer of tearaway stabilizer, and you're gonna need two large pieces of fleece, two pieces of burlap, that's for your front and back. You are also going to need a piece for your appliques. And here is the crinkle fabric that we are going to be using. Now you can get this right from Amazon. I'm going to put the link down in the description, and you can see it's just this kind of saran wrap looking type of material. So we're going to open this up and use this. You'll also need some water soluble stabilizer. You'll need applique curved scissors and a pair of heavy duty scissors. You'll need your embroidery thread. I'm using 40 weight embroidery thread, and I have a 90 weight bobbin thread. Now, it's going to be your choice whether you want to go with a standard 11/75 needle, or you want to bump it up and do the 1490. Since I'm going through burlap, I'm going to bump it up to a 1490 needle for this project. I think it'll sew a little bit better with that. And let's head over to the machine and get started. Okay, step number one is going to be to secure your fabric. Now, I did forget to mention, the other thing you need is basting spray. So I used a little bit of basting spray to adhere the orange fleece, and then a little bit of basting spray to put the burlap on the top. And that is only because I do not want this to slip around and move before we get the secure stitch down. Okay, our next step is going to be our applique placement steps. Now we're going to place our fabrics one at a time. I'm going to use this applique scissors to trim around these fabrics. Okay, before you do the next step, grab your water soluble stabilizer, put that on top. Now I am going to use just a little bit of tape to secure those corners down a little bit. Now we can stitch that satin stitch. Okay, the next couple of steps are going to be finishing out the details and the face of the boomerang. Now that we are done with the front side, it's time to work on the back side and add that crinkle material. So you want to make sure that the pretty sides are together. So the first thing we're going to do is put our burlap piece down. Then we want to put our piece of fleece down. And then we're going to add our crinkle material. Perfect. Now I am going to use a little bit of tape to make sure that this crinkle fabric stays where it needs to stay. All right, great, let's head over to the machine. Okay, so when you have this final step, if you have a big, huge, bulky area, and you have a machine where you can raise up the depth of your presser foot, it may be a good idea to do that. So I am actually going to do that now. So I'm going to take it up to 0.12 instead of the normal 0.06. And that is just going to ensure to not have any drag of that foot across the materials. Great, so last steps are going to be to remove this from the hoop, and we're going to trim all of this fabric around here and then turn it inside out. Okay, we have it all turned and ready to go. You can hear the crinkles, and I'm going to stuff it and ladder stitch it closed. Okay, ready to go? I'm just gonna go ahead and ladder stitch this closed and I'll be right back. Okay guys, we have the final product done and we have Miss Nala, our 13 week old German Shepherd puppy. We're gonna see what she thinks of it. What do you think, Miss Nala? Did we do a good job? Oh, I think she likes it. Good girl. That was a really fun project and it's Nala approved. So I hope that you had a great time with this and that you learned something new. Working with burlap, working with crinkle fabric, it's really great what you can do with an embroidery machine. So if you like this video, make sure you smash that like button, you subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Happy crafting!